Shalom, Rastafari. Ran out of tape. We left off right here, and we're gonna go into the tabernacle. You see, first we're tried by fire, and then we're cleansed in and through the word. And so let us continue. And we need to submerge our bodies in the water, in the word. Not just the verse here, verse there. We need to completely soak ourselves. It's interesting, as Imperial Majesty in My Life of Progress of Ethiopia, he speaks about him almost drowning and the waters went up to his almost to his soul. And then he was saved, and that lake has been dried up. Well, I'm getting off track. Well, Jesus said to Peter that what I do now you know not, like saying, like, you're gonna know later on, the washing of the apostles' feet. It's entering the tabernacle, I believe. It's the basin after being tried by fire, being gold, being as gold worthy. You see, and the being worthy, it kind of, it's difficult to explain, but there's a mix between future and past. Moses represents a future, not necessarily shackled by the past, chained by the past, or enslaved by the past. Rather, he's the future, and there's some connection in the time up in the mountain, 40 days, 40 nights, with the temptation of getting Jesus, and be sure this, before I go off track, this, be sure that if you're in Jesus now, is because you were with Jesus since the beginning. So there's some difficult time scenarios and perspectives going on that I'm not going to get into right now, but I probably won't be able to do justice to its dissemination or explanation, but let us go on. So the washing of feet, we're entering the tabernacle, correct? If Jesus does this not, then we have no part in him. Also, His Majesty, if you check out YouTube and Haile Selassie church service or Easter, even, they wash his hands. I believe scripture implies that him that needs to be washed all is clean whole. And why would he need to be washed all? And his hands, rather, well, the radius will go into that. And so this is the layout of the tabernacle. So here's the fire. And here's the washing. I got this idea that these are intermixed. Temptation and then baptism. Well, you see, His Imperial Majesty 1963, he says that fortunate is that generation that learns through the wisdom passed on by older generations than through his own bitter experience. I guess I say that because you don't have to be tried, in a sense. You could get to baptism, you can learn from our mistakes. You don't have to be chained up with the past. And you see, the book is written, but does not necessarily have to play out. You know, your own will plays effect in it. As His Majesty in the intro, he says 4 points, and he even says that he even prays to the Almighty, to the Creator of the heavens and the earth. He says that he prays that His will be the will of the Almighty Creator. It's getting confusing. I'm getting off track. I didn't really prepare for that, so let us continue my mistaken dwelling afar. Well, again, here we have the layout of the tabernacle. And I just wanted to show an idea of of then it shall be a token, a sign in their hand and in their frontal lobe, forehead, in between their eyes. I should raise this up here, but anyways, it gives you an idea of what's going on. This reminds me of the woman that's wiping, that's crying and wiping Jesus's feet with her hairs and with her tears. If Jesus is raised up, someone standing can't do that. So that's why it's such a memorial for her to do that beforehand, before the raising or the crucifixion. As well as, if you recall, the anointing with spices and the oil, that is, as Jesus instructed, must be a memorial for her deed. It's an example of the tabernacle. He's being prepared right around here with oil before the altar of incense. So I'm not too familiar with it, but something to that idea, as well as shittim wood and him being hung on trees. So it gives you an idea of the similarities, which is what I'm here to express. Now here, if she were to be crying, and you know, at feet level, it's kind of what I was trying to say. And this is another representation of the tabernacle in its fullest. He is the candle, he is the light. And then, coincidentally enough, there's seven people around it. Seven is the closest, the most. I'll leave that at that. I kind of dazed off. It's the way, the number of circles that can be unified the closest, with closest proximity here. Let us continue. And so, in the beginning was the word was with God, and then the light was the life, and the darkness comprehended it not. So if I and I was to be darkness, I and I would not comprehend a light. So in the beginning, there's light. So the beginning is the burning altar, the altar of sacrifice. And then we are born again, baptized. You see, anything that opened, anyone that openeth the matrix shall be sacrificed for Israel's sake. God bless you. But then that openeth the, those born of my children I will redeem. And so if we openeth the matrix and through our cleansing after being tried, and we are of light and comprehended, then we continue on into the tabernacle as redeemed children. And this again is a representation of salvation. Even that looks like I and I is a candle, right? And so you could see Lalibela and rising or going down of the sun. Now, if you look up radius, you know, this system calls it remote authentication dial-in user service. Interesting. It's the networking protocol authorization, the AAA. I mean, authentication, authorization, and accounting. We'll call it the SOST Aleph. Or the source meaning three, and Aleph, the we could even call it the Aleph Trinity. I don't even know if you spell it that way. I'm going by some, but anyways, we could use some of this. This is what the system uses, interestingly enough, for all internet, and so they have the nerve to actually use Yahweh to do wrong. You see, they too require authentication and authorization and the accounting of a certain code in order to allow ones to use internet and such availabilities, which is ridiculous. Being internet should be free, completely free, and anybody should be allowed access. What they do, they set up a code and block your access to it. Nobody has to do any extra work for it. It's a signal and it's out there. All they do is they block it in this process. And I should pray for them that, you know, Jah don't block their access to the Jahnet working protocol, and that they're accounted as, because, you know, just go on. This here is the 3.14, you know, the radius, coincidentally enough, or, you know, chances are, more correctly, faithfully and truthfully, it ends up in your heart. The radius ends up to be the heart chakra, I believe, of Getachi Jesus Christus. And you can see the doorpost, and you can see all the architecture that is related to Ethiopia. And you can see why the lamb's blood was stained where it was. You can see the supports of Hur and Aaron. You could see the Star of David. You could see the pattern of the tabernacle, the light of the world. You could see the stretching forth your hands to God, to Jah Rastafari. You can see the calendar. You can see the lampstand. Pretty much this gives you an idea of how everything is interlinked. And so, what is the authorization? Getachi Jesus Christus, we all know. Well, some of us know. Here is a representation of, you see, I'm not going to explain this. This is Yohannes Rai, Mehraf Arat, which is the vision of John, chapter 4. You can see Lucas, the year of Lucas, Johannes, Mateus, and Marcos. I just want to, this is the Selassie, which you can see the Selassie Trinity symbology. If you could, I don't know if you could see this, but this gives you an idea of death. And you could see the winds. You could see the east wing, the southern wing, the northern wing. You could get a death into, there's more beyond here, and there's stuff in front of this, and gives you the dimensions. And if you could see, these are all lights within the lampstand, and well, you can get an idea of how everything is connected. And this is a perfect way to, so that you could see a different perspective. This right here is the cube, which is a four-sided creation, as well as, you know, it's mentioned in the building of the tabernacle, and it shall be four-sided. And then, well, it could also be round, which is what I mentioned regarding architectural strategies in Ethiopic buildings. But let us continue, or let us continue beginning. So I hope this information has been helpful. I pray that I and I can share in life more abundantly, come to better reasonings and better understandings, and feel free. Check us out at the LOJSociety.org. Visit the Yahoo groups. I opened an account. It's pretty easy. Whatever it takes, do whatever you can. So So God bless, you know. May you be, may the spirit of Kitachin Yesu dwell upon the eye. Shalom Rastafari.